Hello and welcome, welcome to HomeBuildBox. In this video I'll be showing you how to add a skeleton to an OBJ and how to animate it. If you want to see how to create the actual skeleton from scratch, watch video 1, I'll be uploading it very shortly. So I'm going to make a whole complete set on how to animate. Let's say you have a character and you want the arms, the legs, the head, the hair, everything separate. We want to animate it all and then bring it all in as one thing. I'm going to show you how to do it. So all the models are available. So you'll get this model here, and you're going to get, I'm going to show you this part. You get the hand, and you're going to get this thing. This here is a button, which is for the video, so I can actually animate it. All the models are free of charge. This one is exactly as it is. So that's how it looks. So if I go in here, you can see the hand. This is the hand. Wireframe, so we can go to hand in here. For some reason, it doesn't actually color the whole hand in, but as you just saw on the video, the whole hand is actually colored in. I don't know why Windows shows you like that. Okay, so what you do is you go under my video, click on download, you download the folder, and the folder you get is that folder. So, in order to unpack it, if you don't know how to do it, right click on it. And then go extract here, left click that, and then basically it unpacks like that. Yours won't say that, yours will just unpack it, say yeah, and it comes here like this. Once you've unpacked it, go into file, so let's click the hand. Pretend now we've just downloaded it, we've got 10 minute videos, so we're going to keep it short. So go to file, come down, import OBJ. So go to the OBJ, this is the button, so we import the button. Okay, now go back to file. Come down, go back down to OBJ, import the hand. So we got the hand, we got the button, but we got no way of animating the actual hand until we bring in the skeleton. Okay, because it's an OBJ, the skeleton is separate. Go back to file, import. We're looking for motion capture. It's called a BVH folder. Just click on it. It's in the folder. There it is there. Click on it. Two left click opens it, or you can left click. And then go import. Okay, when you import it as an OBJ, it's set to the side. Just if you can't see this, just press this yellow box, go to rotation, type in minus 90, then just click somewhere else and it lines up. Okay, now at the moment this and this one are not together. I'll show you the hand is separate. Look, sorry, the mesh is separate and the hand is separate. I'm showing the OBJ version first because I'm showing you how to attach things together. So what you need to do is click on the triangle on the hand itself. So click the triangle, press Control on the keyboard, and then left click the skeleton. Go over here, press Objects, come down to visit parent, go down here where it says with automatic widths, press that. Now if you click open it, you can see the hands inside here. If I move the hand again, you can see it's still not part of the skeleton, but it is. So if you take the skeleton and move it, everything moves. Okay. Now we can actually animate the hand. So what we want to do to animate it, we need to go to animation mode. To do that, make sure you click on here, left click that. Go over here, go to pose mode. Scroll your camera in so you can get a kind of a good look at it. Because it's an OBJ, when I click on the actual character, it automatically saves out the default pose of the 250 frames. Just left click inside that joint, the one you're working on, say that joint there. Left click inside there, left click, hold, left click here, hold and drag it. Left click and then delete it. Left click it again, make sure you're actually on it. Okay, right click, left click, obviously insert frame, but don't do it yet. I'll show you. Make sure it's on frame 0. Okay, so click on the actual knuckle, right down the knuckle part. Okay, or you can have that knuckle there, or this knuckle here, doesn't matter, wherever you want it. So click on the knuckle, right click, insert animation, and then if you leave it where it is, location and rotation, you put a little dot there. Now I can animate that now if I want to. So if I move it, say, number 20. Just left click, hold and drag it. OK, Okay, now what I want to do, I want to bring this button in like this, not like that. If you make a mistake, just copy that, press undo. Okay, so what I want to do, I want to obviously bring that button in there and touch that. So put the angle of the camera somewhere half decent. So about there. It doesn't matter how many times you move it, it only adds when once you save it, turn it to the side view, then obviously click on the white side to where you want it. Have a look. The finger's okay, the finger's a bit crooked. So I'm thinking, okay, I need to go rotate the finger, not that way. Okay, so I'm trying to work out how to actually rotate the finger like that. So it's got to get the angle of the camera in a really weird position. Just click on the knuckle, bring the button back in. Okay, so once you've kind of lined it up where you want it, we can bring the finger back in and touch the animation. Okay, that's touching the side of my finger. Well, you get the idea. So you're just kind of trying to sort that finger out. Because I don't want to do that. That's it, like that. Perfect. Okay, so that's kind of how I want it. So I want to, it's a bit too far in. So just put it out a bit. Once I kind of mess around with it and kind of get it where you want it, once you are happy with the animation, right click, left click, left click. You put another dot in here, look. So now when you press the button actually works. I've got 10 minute videos, so I'm trying to keep everything kind of short and sweet. Okay, now, of course, I'm going to show you how to move the finger. If you want to obviously put the bones in front, so you can actually see the bones themselves. If you click that, if you come down this menu, press on the bone, and down here somewhere, I think it's this one here, view, press in front, you can see all the bones. There's all the bones there, look. I don't like to see the bones, I don't, so I just leave that turned off, because I just basically roughly guess where the finger is, and then I'll show you what I mean. So, because obviously, if I click on whatever joint that I want to click on, and then I'll go down to here. Because it's default, as I said, you're going to have to delete that. The first animation is there, just delete it. Click on the joint you want, whichever joint you want. Right click, insert, left click. So it's right click, left click, left click. Move it to 20. And now at 20, I want her to bend her finger. And then I'm going to right click, left click, left click. And now she's going to move her finger and her thumb at the same time. Like that. I think it's brilliant. Now she's pinching something. Go back to top view because that finger is completely in the wrong place. Okay, don't worry about that. Go to whatever joint you want, whatever finger you're looking at, whatever joint, whatever you want to click on it. Okay, not that one. I want this joint here, this joint right there. Okay. And now I want to just basically rotate her finger so it's kind of straight, so it looks a bit more natural. Then right click, insert. So right click, left click, left click. And now, when I look at the actual video, now it looks a bit more better. Okay. Obviously, you would animate a lot more better than that. But I'm saying you kind of get the idea of the animation part. Now, that's the OBJ version. Now, if you don't want to load in the mesh, if you don't want to load in the hand and the mesh separately, you can import it as an FBX if you want to. Okay, if you want to do it that way, you can. So if I just get rid of that and get rid of that, as I've got 10 minute videos, go back here, import FBX, load in the FBX, the hand comes straight in, the bones are already there, and of course it's all ready to animate, so just click on it. So if you're pretty new at videos, you might prefer to use the actual animation itself. Playing the actual FBX thing itself here. So as you can see, look, I can just move the basic finger straight away. I don't need to do no work. I can go directly into animation straight away. Obviously, of course, you'll set the fingers up properly the way you want them. I'm just going to roughly just kind of move my fingers. I've got 10 minute videos, so I'm trying to keep everything quick. As you can see, it's a whole lot quicker if you just load in the FBX. Put the finger back like that. Okay, now, as you can see, that's how fast it was if you use an FBX, because you're not bothering with the skeleton, it's already all built in. So anyway, I'm showing you both ways just in case you want to learn that way. Anyway, I'm running out of time. Thanks very much for watching. See you in the next part. Thanks very much. Bye.